don't know why I'm not talking. Guess there's not that too much to say. So I just put in the I'm used to doing the other tutorials. Hey, what?
That's what, if I ever send you to the store,
that's what you want? Okay. With the rooster on it, okay. Okay, so I just put in the Rejuvenique oil, like all around my hairline, where all that new, now it's mostly going back in my hair because it's gotten long enough now that it kind of goes back. And, okay, then I put a little bit of oil in, then I put some blowout cream in there, and now I'm going to use the Rejuva beads. And I like two pumps of the Rejuva beads, and they say to put it on your ends and then leave it in a minute. You can put too much in. That's why it's so hard. Okay, it says to leave it in a minute and then comb. So that's what I'm going to do. Let me get my drink real quick. And I did buy two. This is the brush that Morgan uses. She gets it at Sally's. It is the Technique 390 Technique. I think it's Cricut. And then I don't think I've ever tried one of these. One of those that's kind of concave. So I thought I would give it a try. She said this is one of their best-selling brushes. And then my blow dryer is the Elkin. Let's see, it's their healthy hair or whatever, the one I've been telling you about. Okay, so now I'm going to, think tomorrow I want to wear my hair down the middle. So that's one thing. My mom said that since she's been using Monate, that she does not need any, she doesn't use any of that stuff I just used. She doesn't even use the oil. I gotta take her the oil. But she said now she doesn't need any of her, you know, like she was using a detangler and all that kind of stuff. So, and tonight I used the Renew Shampoo, my favorite combo, Renew Shampoo and Revitalize Conditioner. Okay. So, I might have to speed through this. We'll see. I would put I've got on a bra, so don't worry that I'm gonna expose anything, but I would have put it lower, but I was scared that it might be offensive to someone, and this lighting is terrible, and I just did all of my skincare, so I've got on, if my face looks shiny, it's because I've got my Obagi going on. Okay, the first thing I do usually is just, I like to get that volume right at the root, but if I were to just turn my head over and dry it crazy upside down, it's just too crazy. So I go to my bangs, and see how I'm pulling them kind of down and then out? And the sides of my hair are just damaged the worst. So, have to be careful with them. This is how you get that volume in the back. Either one of the legs. Just keep doing like that. But I still want to keep it parted down the middle. Okay. Not as good with this hand. I do like this brush. Morgan said no matter what brush she gets from any company, and she always gets back to this brush. I looked down here than last night. So. Okay. I'm going to mess myself up here. Okay. I feel like the top is worn out. You can see I'm not the best. I don't blow it out the whole section of your hair off. It just doesn't work that great for me. So I just kind of do this, and then I'll go over it with my big 2-inch curling iron, and that will get it more smoothed out. Now, when I know I am getting to the end, oh, I hate that, I go and plug in whatever hair tool I'm using, and I store them in my garden tub. So today I'm going to use the 2-inch hot tools, and I plug it in, and I usually curl my hair over in John's sink, but what I'm going to do is plug it in and let it be heating up, and then I'll move it over here. So, be right back. Okay, now I'm gonna use this bigger brush and do the crown of my head. And before I forget to tell you that you can adjust the heat on that curling iron, and I have it at 350. Do not ever put it up to like 400. Okay, so what I usually do is just make sure I have the heat going towards the roots. I'm not really trying to curl it that much. Just maybe put a bend in it, but I want the body. I don't know if you can see all that. Those new spreads, like right there, of new hair. And then I kind of blow dry underneath it, that under hair right there. Okay. Then I usually just let this sit in here for a few minutes. Like I might go just sit down and watch TV for a minute, or go get a drink. Or I'm drinking my addiction, this kiwi strawberry ice drink. It's like it's a water drink. It's a soft drink, but it's marketed as a flavored water. And it's my favorite. Okay, so you'll see that gives me that oomph in the back. So let me just make sure it's all dry. I probably could make this work. Just maybe flatten out the other. But you know I'm going to sleep on it tonight. So, okay, let's see. I'm going to unplug this. I don't think I'll need it anymore. Sometimes I think I've got it all dry. So here is my curling iron. And I don't have to put on like an additional heat protectant because everything in my Nate has heat protectant in it. So this comb, I love it. It's the one that Annalie and Jesse on her their channel, she suggested. So I usually just part my hair down the middle like that. And I've got two ways of doing things. Let me do the long way, hold on. Okay, so this is one way I do it. I take this great big Velcro roller and I grab the crown of my head right here. And I brush it out. And then I take this and basically smooth it out. Like that. I'm basically just smoothing it and it's not even tight. Like I could pull this right out. This is one of those curling irons that the clamp doesn't go down real hard, but I don't like the ones that the clamp does go down really, really hard, so but anyway, I just leave it in there like that, take it out, and then take this Velcro roller, and you want it to be kind of tight right at the root, and then I put that there. Okay, then I start in the very back of my neck, and I grab that hair. This hair back here feels so good. My unabused hair. Okay. And I just curl each piece away from my face. This is true love, you guys, doing this video with no makeup on and this bad lighting. So you should always hold your arms out. Okay, so then it's let it out and see, it's gonna just do this. It's not really a curly curl, and it's basically slices of hair. See how it's like the whole section. And I curl each one of them away like that. And this curling iron just doesn't get as hot as the one, like that gold metal one that's this size. I like the one that's got the purple coating on it. Okay, right here. This section can get hokey. Sometimes I just take that whole section and curl it. It just depends on how much curl I want, but just for this video's purposes, I'm gonna section this off. And at one point, this hair right here was so short, broken off so bad. It was right when I was going to first went to Morgan. All that hair above my ear had broken off. So I'm thankful that it's mended. Okay, I've learned I like to keep my bangs in with this section. And there's all my new hair right there. Okay, and so this is kind of squirrely because I've got all these different layers in here. So sometimes I do have to go back and kind of just run it through there like that. Okay, now if you want like more up here, then take these top pieces like this. You get when it gets wrapped around the knobs, and put a little bit more wave like up towards the top of your head like that. Okay, and this is the Monate Refinish Control Hairspray, and you have to shake it up good, because when I first started using it, I probably just did like that one time. But you really have to shake it because it has that Rejuvenique in it. And and I just usually do like that, because I'm not really spraying a style. I'm just kind of spraying. I mean, I want it to hold some, but not crazy. Okay, so now I do the exact same thing. I pull this hair around and then pull that back. I start with this back section. It's like a slice of hair. It's the whole way up. And I know that like beachy waves and all that kind of stuff are the thing. And I love it, like when Morgan does my hair and she does it with the flat iron and leaves the ends out. But I'm having to use my phone as the mirror since the phone's right there. But yes. Are you home? I'm doing a video.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you want to see it?
Uh-huh. Oh, that's so cool.
I know.
Yeah, I'm home.
Okay.
We went to his house. His car is getting like worked on or something.
Uh-huh.
So we had to drive his dad's car, and his dad's car is like really high off the ground.
Uh-huh.
And it's like Jeepy kind of,
uh-huh.
But it's like really big.
Well, that was nice for his dad to let you use
it. And we like met his dad. His dad was like, he's all military, so he's like manly looking.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, he looks like 20, because he's 30.
Oh, did you have a good time?
I did.
Good. Okay. So, and then this one I'll split into another section. When all that new hair right there comes in, I will have some major, major body. It's all about, probably about an inch long, you know, or 3/4 of an inch, I would say. See how much that just smooths it? Okay, so this crazy front piece, I try to put it all together so that I don't like it when my bangs get real separate from the rest of my hair. And I just can't, all that new stuff, I just can't catch it in this curling iron or in a round brush. And I don't want to flat iron those pieces because I don't want to burn them right from the beginning. Give them a little bit of a chance to grow up, but I'll burn them later. Okay, so this is that piece that I was saying, if you want to, sometimes I might want a little bit of height right there. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna take this hairspray again and kind of just give short little bursts. Okay. Okay, now I take this piece out. Kind of just do like this until I can get to it. Put that clip in there, put it back. I have a messy bathroom, but it's an organized messy bathroom. I don't know if you're like that. It's like, it's just because I got so much stuff, but everything has its place. Okay, so I usually split this little section into at least 3, sometimes 4 sections. And I curl these pieces. That one was kind of lame, wasn't it? So you've got the height. Some of you might have to turn the heat up on this curling iron. Sometimes it's just Okay, I think I'm just gonna do three pieces. So this one, I think I'm gonna just do this way. It's gonna look crazy for a little bit. And then this piece, I'll probably see that end. The end doesn't catch sometimes. Yeah, there we go. I don't care about the end that much now because I already know it's tucked under from that. And I was just thinking, if somebody zooms in on my underarms, I go to get my wax appointment is tomorrow. I've had somebody do that before on a picture. They zoomed in on my underarms when I was, matter of fact, it was the first time I had ever waxed. So I had to, it was when you have that crazy time when you have to let it grow out. So rude. I don't know who even thinks of doing that. But anyway, okay, so here it is. Like that. So what I usually do now is I'm gonna unplug everything and I clean up and then I'll show you. Okay, so now that I have it like this, what I do is turn over. And I don't know if you can see me, I lightly gather it up. Now I take one of these curly things and I do like a very loose messy bun, and see my bangs are getting long enough now that they are going in it, but I like to kind of bring them down and then pin them right here because otherwise that it'll have the McDonald arches, and that doesn't bother me that much. I think it bothers other people on me more than it bothers me, but most of the time that's what I do. Looks like a hairstyle off of Little House on the Prairie. And then this is how I sleep. So thanks for watching, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.